on January 15, 2000. Huh? It's not January. I'm sorry. Just wanted to make sure you were listening. Now, at 2:01 on June 15, you are now husband and wife. Would you like to kiss your bride? Friends, it's my great pleasure to introduce to you Mr. and Mrs. Gleason.
Six on the second hand to New Year's resolutions. And there's just no question what this man should do. Take all the time lost, all the days that I cost. Take what I took and give it back to you. All this time we were waiting for each other.
So I remember the first time I knew that Mandy and Kyle were meant to be together. We were walking around the lake by my parents' house, where all good discussions are had. And Mandy was telling me how much she loved Kyle and how he was just great. And I hadn't even met him yet. Had I might have thought differently. However, I'm just kidding.
I don't know what day it is. I had to check the paper. I don't know the city, but it isn't home.
However, I knew that they were meant to be together because before I even knew anything else about him, I knew that Mandy was happier and more content than I had ever seen her. So I knew he had my seal of approval already. Mandy's favorite princes growing up were John Smith, Aladdin, and Robin Hood. And I can see a lot of similarities. I mean, the John Smith thing, that's kind of, I mean, the long hair, you know. Few words, powerful words when spoken, right? Robin Hood, got the facial hair thing going on, plays a guitar.
Foxy,
true. And if anyone has ever seen Kyle's running shorts, green, running around in green tights, right? A lot of similarities there.
Wow, you look gorgeous. Good, how are you?
I'm good.
Are you excited? Yeah, I'm saving up.
Are you nervous?
How do you feel?
I feel good.
Straight in a straight line, running back to you.
What a gorgeous, stunning setting that God has given to you this day. The second date for these two dear people took place right here. And what happened? Did you give her something? A kiss. Their first kiss was right here. Mandy, Kyle. Marriage, this relationship that you're entering, is the most human, most important human relationship that there is. It's an agreement to come together. It's an agreement that needs to be entered into reverently. And your marriage over time must stand on the strength of your love and the power of faith that you have not only in each other, but God, who brought you together, who gave Kyle a nudge on that second date to give a kiss. Just as two threads are woven together to make, like your wedding dress, a tapestry, your lives will come together and be woven together. The beauty of your relationship is that you have incredible similarities. You both want to not really necessarily be the center of attention. You're more introverted, so you have an interior sense of reality. You can be left alone. You need time to regroup, and you also watch the big picture. Then this is where the difference is. Mandy is a feeler. She loves harmony. She doesn't necessarily like conflict. She wants people to get along, and she wants things to work well together. And Kyle, you're a thinker. There's an understanding for a thinker that A is to connect with B, to connect with C, to connect with D, and that systems are challenged if there's not fairness, if things do not work well. It's often in the plans we make that God intervenes somehow or nudges somehow, and on a second date there's a kiss and life changes. That there's something that comes along and life changes. And that's really the key to love, is to be paying attention to this moment in time, because God is at work here with you. With unfailing love.
With unfailing love.
Kyle, I will stand by you.
Kyle, I will stand by you.
Through the best and the worst.
Through the best and the worst.
Through the difficult and the easy.
Through the difficult and the easy.
As I have given you my hand to hold.
As I have given you my hand to hold.
So I give you my life.
So I give you my life.
To keep.
To keep.
So help me God.
So help me God.
With unfailing love.
With unfailing love.
Mandy, I will stand by you.
Mandy, I will stand by you.
Through the best and the worst.
Through the best and the worst.
Through the difficult and the easy.
Through the difficult and the easy.
As I have given you my hand to hold.
As I have given you my hand to hold.
So I give you my life.
So I give you my life.
To keep.
To keep.
So help me God.
So help me God.
First of all, I'd like to start out by saying I'm not very funny and I didn't prepare anything. But I really like math. And I brought a presentation of solving some quadratic equations. And anyone who's interested, later on we can do that. Foil.
Hold on to hope, love. I've searched high and low for you. Each day gets closer, so hold on stronger to me. And yeah, someday soon I'll find.
Well, it's been a long time coming for Kyle, and I have been together for. I've been around you since I was born. I met you the first day I was born, Mandy, in the last couple years. It's been very nice getting to know you. So, welcome to the family.
The I'm really happy for Kyle. I've never told him how much I love him. Kyle, I love you. And Mandy, I'm glad to welcome you to our family. I wish you many joys of years to come.
Own kind of weird. We can all just put it on the table. Okay, we're good? Okay. And in Mandy's, this packet, which we've all been introduced to, the cover of it reads, "We are all a little weird, and life is weird. And when we find someone whose weirdness is compatible with yours, we join up with them and fall into mutual weirdness and call it love." I think there are a few couples that reflect that as wonderfully as the two of you. I would not have called this myself.
Very excited to be here with Mandy today, and I'm very excited everyone could join in. It's a very special day for us. Glad you were all here to enjoy it with us.